Hey guys, this is AIGaming1776, and I am here to have an important and honest discussion with you about how NVIDIA's Pascal graphics cards throttle. Now, before you get your pitchforks out, before you give the video a downvote, please just listen to me for a moment, alright? I am coming to you from a place of goodwill, alright? I have purchased four GTX 1070s with my own money to test them, and I've got a GTX 1060. Okay, on top of that, I have several, almost all actually, of NVIDIA's Maxwell cards to compare to also. If you've watched my channel for the last year and a half, you'd be fully aware that I give some of the deepest digs when it comes to how cards really perform in gameplay. Not benchmarks, not just farting around a little bit in a game, but full on knowing where the best and worst spots are in each game. I can take you to Grand Theft Auto 5. You watch my videos, and I will show you where the highest frame rates are and where the lowest frame rates are and how to find them reliably. So guys, I'm coming from a good place here, all right? If you haven't heard some of the information I'm going to share with you in this video, chances are other reviewers have not had a chance to notice it. You see, I prefer to dig really deep into my games and my hardware. And unlike a lot of big YouTubers, I don't have to go through 30 different graphics cards a year. I can focus on the ones that I've purchased with my own money, and I can just test them at an incredibly deep level. All right, so let me put on my glasses. Again, just hold on to your pitchforks for a minute, and let's get into this. All right, this is a GTX 1070 for the win from EVGA. And yes, I'm using Afterburner to overclock it. It still performs incredibly well, so I don't think it's going to be that big of a deal. Our power limit is at 112%. Our core clock is at plus 118, but it's already a factory overclock card. The memory clock has nothing added to it, and then the fan speed is at 83%. Now let me start up the division, and keep in mind we're playing on a 1440p screen. Now, really quickly, while this game is loading, I know a lot of you may take issue with the fact that I'm using a camera. All right, listen, even Paul's Hardware and Jay's Two Cents use cameras. Now, why they do it, I can't speak for them, but I can tell you why I do it. I do it because if you're going to test hardware and you're going to show people how the hardware performs, I think it's a bad idea to use even Shadow Play. I know a lot of people think, oh, well, Shadow Play isn't that bad, and you're right, it's not that bad, and it has probably the lowest frame rate hit of all recording software, but it's still not as good as using a camera. All right, it's really the best idea to try to record with something that's not your gaming computer. All right, so look in the upper right hand corner where you can see the OSD, on screen display, Afterburner overlay, whatever you want to call it. Look in that upper right hand corner, you will see that we are at 2114 megahertz for the clock speed. Now, it's 49 degrees, and as soon as we hit 51, 52, 53 degrees, that 2114 is going to go down to 2101. All right, this is repeatable, this is predictable, this is something that I've seen over and over again. All right, we're at 51 degrees. It actually, there we go, 2101 at 52. Normally it does it at 52 degrees for me, but when I tried to make this video earlier, it actually did it at 51. Now, the reason I'm showing you this is for some reason, there's been a lot of arguments on the internet about whether or not heat makes Pascal throttle. Well, I'm here to tell you it does, all right? I've even used a water-cooled GTX 1070 to completely take heat out of the equation, and to be honest with you, that card performs fantastically. And of course it would, it's water-cooled, it's an MSI Seahawk X. But this is a for-the-win card, and honestly, for an air-cooled card, it's pretty darn amazing. Like, I'm very impressed with how quiet the card is, how well it overclocks, the thermals. I'm impressed with all of it. All right, we're gonna move the camera again. Now, I told you I have four 1070s. One is a Founders card, and as we all know, those do not cool themselves very well. Although it overclocks fairly okay, it can keep just at 2000 megahertz, and if I'm honest with you, I think if I water cooled it, it might hit 2100 if it was water cooled. But that Founders cooler is just, it's not up to the task at all. So my Founders cooler, the best I'm going to do, even when I turn the fan speed up, and I'm sorry for all of the moving of the camera, guys, I really am. I normally keep my camera still, but I'm zooming in on things for you, and I do live demonstrations here. let me fast travel to where we want to go. I do live demonstrations all the way through without edits, just to show you guys that everything's on the up and up, that everything I say is happening, that's what's happening on the screen. Anyway, the Founders card, it can actually keep 2,000 megahertz. It cannot at all go anywhere near 2,100. As you can see, this is at 2,100, but it won't stay there, okay? As this card gets warmer, actually it just did, it went to 2,088. It really only takes going to probably 56 degrees, which is where we're at right now. It really only takes going to 56 degrees. I'm trying to make that easier for you to read. For the core clock to go down. Now we're at 2,088 megahertz. And this is repeatable, guys. I can do this as many times as you want me to do it with this graphics card, okay? This is a repeatable thing. So, to put it bluntly, yes, Pascal throttles, all right? And we're at 2,088. I could play the game right now for an hour straight, and it would actually stay at 2,088 because this fan is that good. The fans on this ACX cooler are that good at keeping the thermals down. I've seen the temperature get up to maybe 65 degrees, but even in this game, it usually stays around 60. Now, that's pretty impressive because my Founders card, the best that'll do is 72 degrees, and 72, even 74 degrees is the best I can get out of my Zotac amp card. I have videos showing that for both of those cards. And this performs incredibly well. I mean, this is a very, very satisfactory experience, all right? So maybe it'll get up to 65 degrees, even if I play for an hour. And that's important. A lot of guys, when they test these Pascal cards, they're not letting them heat up. I'm going to tell you right now, it takes between 20 minutes and an hour and a half to really get the whole graphics card hot, including the VRMs, and that's gonna start affecting your core speed, all right? It just does. So 2,088, if I played for an hour, it would stay there, all right? It won't go any lower. So that's, I know that from experience with the card, that's pretty good. What I don't know from experience and what we're gonna find out together, we're gonna go on a little journey here, is let me turn the fan on to auto. Let me start the game right back up. Let's find out with the fan on auto, with the card overclocked, let's sit here and find this out together, what temperature it gets up to and what clock speed it goes down to, all right? That's going to be very interesting to find out. And also, I want to tell you guys this while the game's loading up here. I do real game testing. When I make videos for you, when I make videos and I tell you how a graphics card performs or how a game performs, I do real gaming. I could just run the benchmark, which is what a lot of YouTubers do for this game. They just run the benchmark. But the benchmark isn't going to give you the real story. On top of that, I've had a lot of people, see, this is not my first Pascal video. And, you know, at the start of the video, I was like, hey, I'm really honest, I'm really thorough, maybe you don't know that. The reason I felt like I had to say that is one of my videos, it's got 15,000 views right now, which it's not a lot, but my channel's small. You know, I have 2,700 subs somewhere in there, so 15,000 views, that's fairly decent for a channel my size. And a lot of people just were not used to, wow, it's already down to 2,076. All right, it already went down to 2,076 for the core clock, and I'm telling you right now, I played for an hour straight earlier, and it stayed at 2,088, 2,063, all right? There's a direct correlation to the heat going up, the temperature of the GPU going up, and that core clock going down. And if you don't believe me, after we see how far this core clock goes down as the card heats up, we will go back and put it back to 83% fan speed. At 83% fan speed, that core clock is going to stay at 2,088 megahertz. So anyway, a lot of people in the comments for the one video where they got really upset when I said that Pascal cards throttle, they told me about how they used benchmarks, whether it was 3D marks tests, whether they used Firestrike, or I think TimeSpy's the new one. By the way, 2050 megahertz. You see that in the upper right-hand corner, 2050. I'm telling you right now, 83% fan speed, it won't go to 2050. That is the very definition of thermal throttling. Now, for some reason, there are YouTubers who are gun-shy about saying Pascal thermal throttles. And I don't really know why. Because it does. I've seen YouTubers try to change the definition of what thermal throttling means, where they try to say, oh, well, we're not going to call it thermal throttling until the card tries to shut itself down or something. And that's just ridiculous, all right? If the card being hot makes the clock speed go down and the frame rate go down, the card is thermal throttling. It's that simple. And I'm not trying to hurt anyone's feelings or even be a jerk for that matter. Actually, 2050 might be as low as it's going to go. See, I've mainly done balls to the wall overclock testing so far, and I had not tested it with the fan speed on auto. As you can see on that top line, the fan speed is at 40%. In case I didn't make it clear earlier in this recording of the video, that 40%, that's the fan speed. The 99%, that is the GPU utilization. All right. 41% fan speed. That's interesting. 2050 might be as far down as it goes. All right. We're only going to very briefly engage in this battle. But in a second, I'm actually going to quit and I'm going to lower the fan speed manually to something like 25%. And I am pretty certain that 2050 is going to go down. All right, I think, well, it just went to 74. I don't see the auto fan is only at 42% right now, and it's only in the low 70s. I don't think we're going to get a higher temp. I don't think the card's going to let itself get higher than 73, 74 degrees. So let's go ahead and manually change the fan speed. Yes, I want to quit. Let's go ahead and do that. All right, and yes, I use a cough drop. If you guys have watched my videos for a long time, you'll know I've got sinus problems, so I've got to use a cough drop. Sorry about that. It just makes it easier to get through the videos. All right, we're loading up. We have 25% fan speed. Nothing else has changed. At 25% fan speed, the card should be able to get warmer. I think as it gets warmer, we're going to see that core clock speed, that's going to go down. Those megahertz, that top line, pretty sure that's going to go down. So, sorry, I know I'm like chewing this cough drop right in your ear. I apologize. I know there are YouTubers who are, for whatever reason, they don't want to say that the card thermal throttles. And they want to change the definition of it and everything. I don't know why they're doing that, guys. But I think it's a disservice to the community. I really do. Like, I almost, and I know YouTubers get mad when they get accused of this, but I almost wonder if NVIDIA has talked to them, you know? Like, oh, that's not thermal throttling, that's GPU boost 3.0, which, by the way, we will do more videos after this, because it's not just thermals that make the card throttle. As a matter of fact, with my water-cooled, it's an MSI Seahawk X, with my water-cooled GTX 1070, that card throttles too, but not very much, not very often even. Oh man, the game crashed. I wonder why, actually. Oh, maybe it's because of the... You know what? It could be the fan speed was too low. All right, let's make it 30%. Let's try that. It might have got way too hot at 25%. I've not had this game crash yet. So hopefully it does not crash again. Because I really want to get that temperature jacked up. The thing is I can't believe I'm going to have to say this. The EVGA cooler is like too good. Right? Like if we have to rely on auto, that thing is going to keep it in the low 70s. Whereas my Zotac amp card and my Founders card, both, man, they're not as good, guys. They're really not. You know, the Founders card can get up to, I think, 83 degrees if I leave it on auto. The Zotac amp card, it stays in the 70s, but the fans ramp up to do that. You know, 65, 70, 75% on the auto profile. All right, let's start the game again. Hopefully it doesn't crash because I don't want to make this video take forever. I don't want to be here all night. You don't want to be here all day watching it. Neither one of us want to spend more time with this than we have to. Anyway, what I was telling you is my water-cooled 1070, that card also throttles. And it does a little bit due to temperature because unfortunately it does go up to 65 degrees. And we saw with this card, when it goes up to 65 degrees, that this card also throttles. So, and remember, my definition of throttling just means the core clock is going down. The clock speed goes down. All right, we're at 30%. But the water cooled car does, but not that often. And honestly, it really, it has gotten as high as 65 degrees, but it usually stays in the 50s. I've only seen it go into the 60s one time, whereas it normally goes up to about 54 degrees at the hottest, but it still throttles. And I think the reason is power conservation, if I'm completely honest, is I think the way Pascal tries to conserve power, I think that is going to affect your clock speed. All right, I'm trying to get the temperature to go up. We're at 2,063 megahertz, 70 degrees, and another degree or two, it's going to jump down to 2050, so just watch. Okay, we're at 70 degrees, 71. It's going to jump down to 2050. 71. I feel like an auctioneer. 71. Can I get a 2050? All right, we're still at 2063. Yeah, this cooler is good. I mean, 72 degrees, even at 30%. 2050. 72 degrees, it goes down to 2050. Guys, this is predictable. To me, this is the very definition of thermal throttling. If I can tell you what the core speed is going to be based on the temperature, that's thermals affecting the speed of the card. So why other YouTubers don't want to say thermal throttles, I don't know. I mean, maybe NVIDIA didn't talk to them. Maybe they just have a different belief. Maybe they're smarter than me, right? Maybe they have read a dictionary, and a dictionary gives a different definition of thermal throttling, and my definition of it's stupid. But I'm telling you, my definition is if the card gets warm and the core clock goes down, but, you know, conversely, if the card stays cool and the core clock is up, you know, that's thermals affecting it. It's throttling it. All right, so we're 77 degrees. We're still at 2050 megahertz, which is pretty baller. That is pretty baller. If you want to know what this card gets up to out of the box, if I don't overclock it, it gets up to like 1930 something. There's a lot of YouTubers who say that their cards, their factory overclock cards, automatically go up to over 2,000. None of mine have. I have four GTX 1070s and a GTX 1060, and none of those cards have gone into the 2,000s on their own. Although that's not entirely true. I've seen them go into the 2,000s on their own, but they don't stay there, right? Like, they immediately go into the 1900s. All right, so we're 2,038 and 79 degrees, 30% fan speed might be too good. We really need to try that 25% again if we can and hope the game doesn't crash, because I need to see this card get into the 80s, I think, to make that number go even lower. All right, it's at 80. Maybe we just keep running. Just running and run. You ever see Forrest Gump? Run. It's getting to the point now where Forrest Gump is probably like way too old of a movie for you guys. By the way, if you're scrubbing through this video, if you're impatient and you're trying to scrub through the video and like see where the money shot is or where I get to the point, and then you hear me talking about Forrest Gump, you're going to find yourself very confused. But you don't want to scrub through my videos. My videos, it's usually, I say worth it. That's an opinion, I guess. But it's usually a good idea. How about that? It's usually a good idea to watch my videos straight through. I know you might be very tempted to scrub through it or whatever, but the entire time this camera is recording, I am talking to you about my experience with the game and or the hardware. All right, we're up to 82 degrees and now it's at 2025. All right. Remember, if we had this clock, but if we had the fan speed set for auto, we'd probably be in the low to mid 70s and we'd probably be at 2050 megahertz at the lowest point. Which honestly is not that bad. That's pretty solid. Now, maybe Precision X would give a better overclock. I don't know. The problem with Precision X is I find their OSD to be very unreliable. That's just been a fact for me. All right? That's something I've had to deal with. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to run back to that mission now, and we're going to see if the card gets any hotter when we're doing a real mission. All right, so GPU is at 84 degrees, which is probably hotter than this card will ever get for you guys, because I'm telling you, the cooler on this is great. So why do I have four GTX 1070s? I'm reminded of that when I tell you how great this cooler is. Well, my Founders card, honestly, the best it could do is 2,000 megahertz. That was the best it could do, 2,000. And I had to have the fan at 85% to do that. And then my Zotac card, the best it could do was even lower. It would settle at like 1928 megahertz, which is awful. I mean, that's like what people get out of the box. So then I got the water-cooled card, and that settled at 2077, 2076, or 85 degrees. 2077, 2076, somewhere in there. And then I tried this card for another air-cooled card, because I've had a lot of people give me comments in my other videos, and they say, well, their air-cooled cards can actually stay in the 60s. And I'm going to be honest with you, I didn't believe anyone, right? I had two air-cooled cards. Neither one could stay in the 60s. And then my water-cooled card, it's reached the 60s. So I was like, you guys are just full of crap if you say your air-cooled cards stay in the 60s. So what did I do? I spent my own money, my own time, my own resources. I ordered this fourth card. I don't need 41070s, right? There's not even real SLI support for 41070s. So I got this fourth card because I wanted to see, okay, can an air-cooled card stay in the 60s, and can it perform well? And to be honest with you, this air-cooled 1070 performs better than my water-cooled one, all right? This one settles at about 2088 megahertz, which is just a little bit quicker than the water-cooled one. And, you know, I have to have the fan at 83% to do that. But even if I have the fan on auto, it looks like it's going to be 2050. Now, I'm going to have to do a real test, like a real probably 2-3 hour test to see what it stays at with the fan on auto. But so far it's looking promising with this card. So look, I'm not here to slam Zotac. I'm not here to say that EVGA is the best. I do believe in the Silicon Lottery. I do believe that, you know, I could try 10 different Zotacs and maybe have 3 distinct different experiences. 87 degrees. All right. I went back down to 84, 86, 87. I think to make that clock go down even lower, we are going to have to lower the fan speed. We're going to have to, man. This ACX cooler is just too good. So I am not here to tell you that if you get a Zotac, it'll suck. And I'm not here to tell you that if you get an EVGA, it'll be great. Can I do 20%? Oh, 25 is as low as it goes. All right, we'll see if it crashes. I can't speak for what's going to happen. Again, you could have 10 different Zotacs and 3 different experiences probably. All right. But my experience of 4 cards, by the way, this is a Founders 1070, right? Founders 1070. This is a 980 Ti classified from EVGA. And then this is a Zotac Amp 1070. By the way, I love this card. It's actually, I think it's good looking, even with the yellow stripe. But my experience has been with these cards, it's been a mixed bag. Two of my air-cooled cards do not stay cool whatsoever. And this air-cooled card stays really cool. You saw that. I mean, it'll stay in the 50s to maybe the lower mid 60s, but most of the time at 1440p, it's staying in the 50s, which for an air-cooled card, that's amazing. Even if the fan does have to be at 83%, that's still pretty amazing. It looks like it's going to crash. So you just stop. Yeah, I think 25% is just not enough fan speed. Will 27 work? I don't think it will. I don't even think you guys are going to get to see this card at its worst. Like, that's how good this cooler is. This card, even at, what did it get up to? 86 degrees, maybe 87 very briefly, 84, 86 degrees. This card still can hold a 2050 overclock. And I'm telling you, my Zotac can't do that. My Founders can't do that. My Founders card has to fight tooth and nail just to hold on to 2000. So the game did not load. Let's try this again. Anyway, I've kind of proven my point. I just want to see how low I can get that clock to go. That's all I'm doing right now. But I've proven my point on the thermal throttling. It is predictable. I can literally tell you, you know what, like we could put the fan speed back to 83%, let the card get cool, start the game, and be at 21:14 again. Like we were at the start of the video. I can predictably correlate the temperature of the card with the speed of the clock. All right, and I've proven that point. So Pascal does thermal throttle. Is Pascal bad for that? No. But I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to tell you this right now. See this 980 Ti classified? All right. That card. No, we can't. Look, we cannot start the game. We literally cannot start the game below 30% fan speed. Watch. Put it at 32% and then it probably won't crash. That classified 980 Ti, that Maxwell card, it operates at 82 degrees. 82 degrees is its normal temperature with the stock fan profile. And it's fairly quiet. It's not the quietest thing I've ever heard, but it's quiet enough, right? Like, it's not a big deal. And I think it gets up to like maybe 56% fan speed or something, 52%, and it doesn't throttle at all. This 980 Ti does not throttle at all. It keeps its clock speed and it never goes down. And I can play for 4 hours straight at 82 degrees and it never goes down. Whereas my Pascal cards do, right? So I know people get offended or they want to be a fanboy or they want to say like, oh, you know, it's not going to throttle because someone told me it doesn't, or it doesn't meet the definition of throttling, but it does. Heat is affecting these cards, and we need to be honest about that. And you know what? Let me say this. Let me try to be. It crashed again. Let me put the fan on auto at this point. No, actually, let's not. Let's put the fan back up to 83%. So let me be magnanimous here. Let me try to be the bigger person here. Let me say, if you want to pick a different way to describe it than thermal throttling, I'll be open-minded to that. But we, as the PC gaming community, we need to agree on some terminology, right? In my mind, this is thermal throttling. Again, if my Maxwell card can be at 82 degrees for 4 hours and the core clock never goes down, but the Pascal card, that clock goes down and down and down, and you saw it. You know, it starts out at 2100 and it hits 52 degrees and it goes down. And then it hits 56 degrees and it goes down. And then it hits 60 degrees and it goes down. And then it hits 65 degrees and it goes down. And then it hits 74 degrees and it goes down. And then it hits, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's thermal throttling, guys, because as soon as you let the card be cool, it doesn't do that. That's got to be thermal throttling, but if you want to call it something else, if you want to give it another name, I'm open-minded to it, right? So I'm going to do at least one more video about Pascal throttling. I can put a link to it in the description for this video. I've already got a video where for more than a half hour, I show how you go to different parts of The Witcher 3, you go to different parts of the map, and the speed on my water-cooled card. Remember, it's water-cooled, so that mostly takes heat out of the equation. Now, the VRMs might get hot, the PCB might get hot, but the core, that's cool. And that water-cooled graphics card, I would go to one part of the map, and it would be, I don't know, 2076 megahertz. And then I go to another part of the map, and it would go down to 2025 megahertz. And it would do that reliably. I can make it do it over and over again. Look at that. 2100 megahertz. At 83% fan speed, 2100 megahertz. What was it? Was it 2114? Because we just hit 55, 56, and it went down to 2101. And you're up 2088 when it went to 56 degrees. This is predictable. And as long as I don't go much over 60 degrees, it'll stay at 2088. It will not go down. All right, that's the takeaway, guys. That is the takeaway. I can predict what speed the clock will be at based on what temperature the card is. So to me, that means thermals, right? Again, if you disagree, then let's have a discussion. Let's talk about what we should call it. But to me, this is thermal throttling. The card gets cool, the clock goes up. The card gets hot, the clock goes down. Thermal throttling. Throttles up, throttles down. Anyway, I feel like my point is proven. If you're a fair and objective person, hopefully you're not going to just give this video a thumbs down just because I said something about Pascal that you didn't like or said something about NVIDIA. Listen, I've given so much money to NVIDIA that it's sickening. All right? It's sickening. I've got a water-cooled 980 Ti and an air-cooled 980 Ti, a 2GB 960, a 4GB 960, a 970. That's Maxwell, right? And then I've got four 1070s and a 1060, all so I can honestly and objectively test this hardware for you. So please believe me when I tell you I am coming from a good place when I make these videos. All right, so thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully this video has been helpful for you. Hopefully it can start a conversation in the community. And by the way, let me just say one more thing. If you're just doing benchmarks or you're doing short gaming sessions, you'll never see the things that I'm showing you, all right? You've got to really play the game. You got to play it for a while. And even the water-cooled card, once you play for about 2 hours, the PCB is getting hot, the VRMs are getting hot, and there starts to be some instability in the performance, all right, even though it's water-cooled. So you've got to get these cards good and hot. We're talking like a good two-hour gameplay session at 1440p with the settings turned up. By the way, these settings may not seem impressive to you, but go ahead and you put these settings on your graphics card at 1440p and see what kind of performance you get. Because these settings, even though it's like medium for the reflection quality and medium for ambient occlusion, trust me, like the division will work your graphics card pretty hard at 1440p. That's why I use it. With my R9 390X, yeah, I test AMD too. With my 390X, I swear to you, my computer honestly feels like a furnace. Like all those jokes about AMD being a furnace. This game at 1440p with a 390X honestly does make my computer feel like a furnace. This game will work your system out at 1440p, and that's why I use it for my testing. Now, a lot of people are like, oh, it's not fair because it's an Ubisoft game. Well, guess what? I think it's dishonest. And I think you are lying as a reviewer if you only pick games that a graphics card is good at. Guys, this is a almost $500 graphics card. And if I only showed you games that this card is good at, I would be lying to you. And then I would be influencing you in a dishonest way to spend your money. I think reviewers need to use games that are really demanding. All right, and not just Crysis 3 or any old BS. They just use Crysis 3 because it scales a certain way. All right, but if you have a graphics card that makes an Ubisoft game play like butter at 1440p, you've got a good graphics card, all right? So there you go. Hopefully this video has been helpful for you. You got to do real two-hour gaming sessions. Don't come at me with that benchmark nonsense. Hashtag benchmarks are not real life. And again, hopefully this video has been useful for you and helpful and informative. Please consider liking it. Please consider subscribing. Please share my videos with your friends, because honestly, that's there's no bigger compliment than word of mouth. So anyway, love you guys so much. Thank you. We're at almost 3,000 subscribers. We just did our 2,500 subscriber thank you video a few weeks ago, and we're almost up to 3,000, so that's pretty decent growth. And I appreciate you guys. I really do. I work really hard and I do very thorough testing. Guys, I've been sleeping 2 hours a night trying to test four different 1070s and a 1060. The 1060 came out 3 days ago. I've been sleeping 2 hours a night killing myself to do these tests. And I know you guys appreciate it and I appreciate you. So thanks for watching, guys. I love you so much. This is video one for Pascal's Throttling. There will be at least one more. Maybe a third, but I think maybe one more is all we're really going to need. This one is thermals, and then we'll do another one for sure, talking about how Pascal tries to conserve power, and then we'll do maybe GPU Boost 3.0. I don't know about that yet. And again, if you think that Precision X would have been better for overclocking this card, I respect that. That is a very respectable stance for you to have. The only reason I'm using Afterburner, honestly, the performance is great, in my opinion. 2076 megahertz. Ooh. Man, I wonder if that's because we got it so hot earlier, because it's at 61 degrees. I played for over an hour earlier, and it did not go below 2088, but it also was really most of the time at like 58 degrees. 61 degrees. Maybe all those shenanigans of playing with the fan turned down like really, really heated everything up. Anyway, 2076 megahertz. This is where my water-cooled MSI Seahawk settles at. So I really don't have any big complaints, all right? And I've praised that water-cooled card. So it's the for the win card from EVGA. It's been a really good card. It's been pretty solid. Hopefully you guys have appreciated this video. Again, I'm rambling at this point. So thanks for watching. Have yourselves an excellent day. Love you. Peace out.